Pay attention to the details of this interview. Loose Change is out to try to prove the government planted explosives in the towers. In this interview, back in 2005, maybe 2006, whenever it took place, Willie, you're going to see in a minute, never even says he heard the plane hit the building. All he explains is two explosions he heard, which turns out to be this, the engines down the elevator shafts. Now, you'll notice that he never says he heard that building get hit by a plane. He only mentions the two explosions. Wouldn't that be hardcore evidence if Willie wanted the truth out in 2005 and 2006, 4 and 5 years after the attacks of September 11th? Why didn't he disclose that information to Loose Change? You could go to Loose Change, the entire video, find it on DVD. You will notice Willie does not say that he heard the plane even hit the building. I'm not lying. Call me out on it. Go to the video and see for yourself. Willie doesn't even mention that he heard in 2005, 2006, whenever this interview took place, that he even heard the building get hit by a plane. He never mentions the plane. But yet, in 2009, he tells Jesse Ventura that he heard it before. What changed the story? I'll tell you that in a minute. Here, listen to the entire Willie Rodreguez interview that was recorded by Loose Change for their video to try to prove the government planted explosives in the towers. Listen close. He does not even say that he heard the plane hit the building. He was in sub-level 1. He could not have heard that plane hit 92, 96 stories above him. The sound would have had to travel back into the building. It couldn't go through the building, the sound. It would only have to go outside, down 92 to 96 stories, back through the inside of the basement and find Willie. Now, he never even heard the plane hit the building. Watch the video for yourself right here. Watch this clip and tell me if he says he heard the plane hit the building. He never does. Check it out.
So what happened in the North Tower? Ask Willie Rodreguez. Willie, a janitor who worked in the World Trade Center for 20 years, was in sub-level 1 when the North Tower was hit.
And all of a sudden, we hear boom! I thought it was a generator that blew up on the basement. And I said to myself, oh my God, I think it's a generator. And I was going to verbalize it. When I finished saying that in my mind, I hear boom, right on the top, pretty far away. So it was a difference between coming from the basement and coming from the top. And that's, everybody started screaming. And a person comes running into the office saying, explosion, explosion, explosion. He got his hand extended and all the skin was pulled from his under his arm, all the way to the top of the fingertips, and it was hanging on both arms, hanging and hanging. And then I look at his face, and he was missing parts on his face. And I said, what happened? What happened? And he said, the elevators, the elevators. And then there were many explosions, and when I actually talk about those explosions, they said that, well, there were so many kitchens in the building, and they have probably those gas canisters, and I said, I don't believe that because the building was a Class A building. There are very strict guidelines of what you can put in a kitchen. And I really doubt it was gas. So there was a lot of misconceptions of what happened that day in terms of the explosions. But up to date, I haven't received an actual explanation about the different explosions that I had on the upper floors and not all the way to the top.
That interview took place before December 2005 or June of 2006. I'm not sure which one when they interviewed Willie, but it was before June of 2006, the second release date. We know that for sure because it was in the video of the release date being June of 2006. At that time, Willie never mentioned hearing the plane hit the building. He mentioned hearing an explosion in the basement and one right on top pretty far away, which turned out to be the engines from the plane. Now, the debut of Jesse Ventura's TV series, Conspiracy Theory, was December 2nd, 2009. So, somewhere around that time, Willie was interviewed by Jesse Ventura, and listen how he changed his story when he told Jesse that he heard the explosions before the plane hit the building. But it seems at least 3 to 4 years before that, he never even mentioned it to Loose Change. the ones who are going after the government to try to prove there was bombs in the in the towers planted by the government. Well, why did Willie change his story? Yeah, listen to this interview with Jesse Ventura, and then I'll tell you why Willie changed his story.
The investigation moves to the banks of the Hudson River, under an empty sky where the World Trade Towers once loomed. The governor meets the last man out of the last tower to fall.
You see that peak over there?
Where the round one
yes,
is?
Yes, correct.
Right there was right where the tower
was. Yes.
Okay.
William Rodriguez was a maintenance worker at number 2 World Trade Center. He has a story that not only contradicts the official 9/11 account, but shakes it to its very foundation.
At 8:46, while we're talking in front of the office, we hear, bah! An explosion, very loud. Push us upwards.
Upwards?
Upwards. All the walls shaked. They cracked. The false ceiling fell on top of us. The sprinkler system got activated. Water started spewing everywhere. Everybody screaming in horror. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
Now, was this a result from the plane hitting?
No. This is before the plane hitting the tower.
This explosion
came from below. But the first thing that I thought it was that it came from the mechanical room that was on the basement number 2. I went to say, you know, it may be when we hear, bah! All the way on the top of the building, and I speculated that it was the plane hitting the tower.
So these two explosions were completely separate?
Completely separate.
The official 9/11 story says hijacked jets brought down the towers, not explosive devices.
If you can remember, how much time would you say was between the two explosions?
6 to 7 seconds difference.
That close?
That close. And I wasn't the only one that felt this. There were the 14 people inside the office.
Did all you people tell this to the 9/11 commission?
I testified for the 9/11 commission behind closed doors.
Why behind closed doors?
Well, my speculation was that they didn't want the story to be out.
How does the last man out get left out of the 9/11 commission report? We've definitely got the makings of a conspiracy.
Willie obviously changed his story when he talked to Jesse Ventura. What would make him change his story? Here is my YouTube channel page. If you look up in the right-hand corner, you'll see Loose Change Exposed. I'll go over to the left. You'll see I'm on Sent Messages. It's highlighted on the left. I go over here. You can see as I pan down. This is what I sent to WRODY on August 22nd, 2009. It was approximately 4 months before the release of the Jesse Ventura interview. It says, I saw you in the YouTube, the Loose Change video. Here is what you heard. And then I sent them the link to 9/11 Engines Down Elevator Shafts. You click on WRODY. Look who it is. It's Willie Rodriguez. I sent him that message and information on about the Engines Down the Elevator Shafts. August 22nd, 2009. Okay, anybody that wants to try to say that Willie never got the message, here is his reply to me. As you can see, it's highlighted on personal messages on my channel, Loose Change Exposed, at the top on the right. It was sent to me August 26, 2009, 4 days later, still about 4 months before the Jesse Ventura interview was aired. And he says, you are totally wrong on your hypothesis. Also, for your information, the engines were not found at the lobby or B2 level, as you assert. Good luck with your research. People were looking for other people, not investigating what ended up in the elevator shaft. Anybody watching this video, please send a link. Please send a video to Willie at WRODY here on YouTube. Let's see what kind of responses we get. Thanks.